John has schizophrenia. People with this disorder are often paranoid.
But his work, he deals with conspiracies, so.
Yes, yes, I know.
In John's world, these behaviors are accepted, encouraged. As such, his illness may have gone untreated far longer than is typical.
What do you mean? How long?
Possibly since graduate school. At least that's when his hallucinations seem to have begun.
What are you talking about? What hallucinations?
One, so far, that I'm aware of. An imaginary roommate named Charles Herman.
Charles isn't imaginary. He and John have been best friends since Princeton.
Have you ever met Charles? Has he ever come to dinner?
He's always in town for so little time, lecturing.
Was he at your wedding?
He had to teach.
Have you ever seen a picture of him? Talked to him on the telephone?
This is ridiculous.
I phoned Princeton. According to their housing records, John lived alone. Now, which is more likely, that your husband, a mathematician with no military training, is a government spy fleeing the Russians?
You're making him sound crazy.
Or that he has lost his grip on reality. Now, the only way I can help him is to show him the difference between what's real and what is in his mind. Come on. What's he been working on?
His work's classified.
He mentioned a supervisor by the name of William Parcher. Maybe Mr. Parcher can clarify things for us, but I can't get to him without clearances.